Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Well, actually, over the next couple of weeks, there's a lot happening over in the morning part of the sky with the planets. So if you look towards the southeastern part of the sky, if you're in the northern hemisphere, around about an hour before the sun rises, peaks above the horizon, we've got three major planets all lined up in a row, starting on the 7th of March, about equidistant from each other. There's Mars, that's the highest, then there's Jupiter in the middle, and then Saturn is lowest, closest to the horizon. I do want to point out that these are not necessarily well-placed right now in terms of how large they will appear in a telescope. It's not to say that you can't look at them through a telescope, but Mars, for example, is less than 6 arc seconds across, so that's pretty small. Jupiter is about at its smallest at around 35 arc seconds across, and Saturn, the disk of the planet, is under 16, and with the rings, you're at 36. So fairly small. Not impossible to view. Mars may not be a whole lot to see. You might see a polar cap, but not a whole lot of other detail. However, if you want to take photographs of the planets as they're moving through the sky like this, with some foreground objects or with the landscape or whatever, this would be a nice opportunity to be able to do that. That won't take up a lot of time either, especially since we're still in some cool weather and it is morning and some of us may be headed off to work. So watch what happens with these planets. Mars is going to be heading towards where Jupiter's at over a number of days. Now we need to back up just a little bit in time, so we still stay about an hour or so before sunset. And as we start to get in towards the next part of the following week, these planets are really close. I mean, initially they started out at about 15 degrees apart. Now we're within about 10 degrees by the 14th, so 1 week. And look what's happening over here. Look at that. The moon is now going to come into play here. So by the 17th, we've got the moon really close, making a nice line in about 20 degrees or so. So that would be a good photograph opportunity. Probably the best one though is on the 18th, because look at how close all of these are together. I'm going to take off the angular here and you can see how close all those are. Look at that. Jupiter, Mars, and the moon are within 3 degrees of each other. So that's binoculars visible easily. And if you have a nice telephoto zoom lens, you can probably get all three of these because they're all within 8 degrees, 8, 9 degrees of each other. So a really good zoom lens is going to capture all three of these together. And the moon is not too terribly bright. Shouldn't wash things out too much. We're looking at a magnitude of minus 10. That's a lot less than the minus 12.7 or so that it can be at full moon. So hopefully that will help and not wash things out enormously. And then as we go forward a little bit more into the rest of that week, we can see how the moon starts to move that way. Now, I do want to bring the time forward though, because look what's starting to come up above the horizon. Then we've got Mercury. You might be able to catch that. That's really low. It's going to be, let's see, the azimuth is only 5 degrees above the horizon right there. You might want to wait another few days. It's actually going to kind of zoom up a little, but the ecliptic line is somewhat low along there at that particular time. So Mercury might be difficult to spot, but it is possible, and you can use the planets that are higher up to help point you at it, because Jupiter and Saturn basically make a line pointing right down that way. Just you're going to need to look a good from Saturn. It will be about 30 degrees, so you'll probably have to kind of use the 15 degrees like this, put together and held apart, and you can measure down there and might be able to catch that just before the sun pops up. But before then, there's a lot of planet stuff happening. If you are up early, and I would encourage you to do so, check these out, especially that 18th. That's just a beautiful grouping of planets and our satellite over there in the morning sky. And if you do happen to look over in the evening sky, Venus is super bright, super high right now. That's another great area for you to take a look if you're just looking for planets and want to take a look at some things for a naked eye view of the night sky. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.